Hello everybody, and welcome to Westbourne and Brush Love Edition. So today, or tonight, depending on when you're doing your board, you will either have a red board or a gray board. So I already did our gray board, and it says, I love you like no mother, with two little gnomes with hearts on it. And then we will be putting a clothespin at the top, and you guys can put pictures of your loves in there. So tonight we're going to paint the red side because you'll have the option of the red stain or the gray stain. The gray will have the red paint. The red will have the white or creamish color paint. So whatever color you choose for that. We are going to do, so in your kit you will have your board already pre-stained for you. You can take a little bit of sandpaper and rough it up if you would like the rustic look. You will have your design. You will have transfer taper. I have a little clothespin, a brush, and then you will have your paint. And for this project, you will need a glue stick or hot glue gun. And then you will need something to poke your design with. So a toothpick and something sharp or like a knife sometimes works too. You will also need a library card or a credit card, something to swipe this with. So with that, we will get started. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna separate our transfer tape from the blue. And we're gonna place it on our design. And you wanna try and get it over all of your design if you can. I of course forgot my scraper, so we're going to improvise. So I'm just going to use my paintbrush here, so anything hard, you can take just a swipe over it. Just like that. Okay, now what you want to do is you want to separate the white and the red. This corner is giving me problems, so I'm just going to use my pokey tool here. Probably easier with a nail if you have nails. You can just grab a little bit of the white and the red and separate it. Okay, so like that. So you want your red and your white to separate. You want everything to stick to this grid transfer tape. So what I suggest you do is you go slowly. Like, see, it's still sticking to the white. His little nose. I'm gonna push down and I'm gonna roll it back. This going nice and slowly to make sure that everything sticks. You just want to keep using your finger to push down, and we'll just keep going here. Doesn't want to stick, you can use your scraper to scrape over it too. Alright. Now that we got that off, we'll set that off to the side. And you're going to take your transfer tape, or your vinyl, sorry, and you're going to put it on your board as straight as you can. What I like to do is if you push it down really hard, it's going to stay there. So if you just set it down gently, just kind of eyeball it, look to see if it's straight. You can measure it. It's 8 inches and your board should be about 9.5. So you can measure it from the farthest hearts over. Otherwise, what you can do is take your design at the bottom and make sure it's straight that way and then just slide it up from there. So however you like to do it, you can do it. So once you feel like you got it all good and everything is good, then you want to push it down. And this is where we don't want any air bubbles because we don't want the paint to go underneath the vinyl at all. So this is where you want to make sure it's stuck on there really good. Alright, so then what you're going to do is you're going to take your transfer tape. You're going to start peeling it away from the red, from your vinyl. So your vinyl will probably be a different color so that you can see a little more clearly what you're painting and everything. just happen to have a spare piece of red, so I just use that up. Just gonna keep smoothing as I go, and you just want to make sure there's no air bubbles. If you find that you're getting a lot of air bubbles, try pulling your transfer tape a different way. Try doing it from a different corner or a different angle. Sometimes that makes all the difference in how you pull it. So once again, going slow, making sure everything is sticking to your wood. We want all the centers of our letters stuck down. So just keep going. All right, so you can set this off to the side, and if you have a Cricut at home, you can feel free to use this again. If you don't, but you feel like maybe you could find another use for it, this stuff is really awesome to transfer an image from one thing to another and not really sticking to it. It always gives it up. So you can set it off to the side. It is reusable. So, all right. So this is all cut with my Cricut. If you got a Cricut for Christmas and you are looking for lessons, I also do that too. And I can help you out with that in a safe way. So once we can know we got everything stuck down, it's good to go. And then we get to start painting. All right, looks so cute. All right. Alright, so there's no rhyme or reason to it. I like to go just one light coat first. You don't have to worry about going a certain direction with this one. I just like to do light strokes, so lighter coat first and then a thicker coat after that. You just want to establish a base coat. So we're just going to paint over it. I know gnomes are really big this year, and I wanted to paint something with gnomes. If you have a gnome decoration already at home, give me a like on this video so we can see how many people have gnomes at home. So once we get one coat on him, like I said, just do a light coat to begin with. Nothing super crazy here. So get one coat in. And then what we will do is we will go back over it with a second coat. If you like more of a rustic look to yours, then I would just leave it with one, because then the red will show through the white and give a little bit of a rustic look to it. If you like it super dirt, like super no color showing through the red, then you're gonna probably wanna do a couple of coats. So I'm gonna let this dry just for a couple of minutes, maybe even like 2 minutes here, and then we'll do a second coat. Okay, it's been a couple of minutes now, so we're gonna do a second coat of white. I did find that the white, or the cream, sorry, covers a little bit better than the red. So if you're doing the gray, the red took me about 3 coats to accomplish what I was trying to accomplish with the darker color. Like I said, you'll be able to see it once it dries what it should look like, so whatever you're trying to accomplish. The fun thing about these boards is that you guys can add to it whatever you would like to add to it. You can add more hearts to it if you'd like. You can add a heart inside of his hat, whatever you would like to do. So these are yours to do as you wish to do, as creative as you would like. So, all right, so we're just gonna give this is, and you just want to make sure your brush strokes are all going the same way for this one, your final coat, so that it makes sure you get everything in there and it looks smooth and the same. What I like to do, just to make sure it's going to dry a little bit faster, and you'll know, is just really make sure you get the excess paint off to know what you're looking at having here. So, with that being done, I'm going to put the lid on this. Now, you want to let it dry for probably about a minute. We don't want to leave it more for that for your last coat if you're planning on peeling this off. I just want to let you know that. So we're just going to give it a minute here. And I just wanted to go over a couple of things with you. First of all, I wanted to give Alivary lots of love for allowing me to come in every month and be able to do these virtually with you guys. I have enjoyed this so much, and I just wanted to say thank you to them, and thank you for all that support me with this. We are going to be offering these every Friday, so Sarah should have some signups coming up soon here, and then you can let her know by every Wednesday of that week what color stain you want, and then I will get your board ready and have it here for Friday. So you guys can pick up, and that will be up until the 12th that we will have pickup available for these. And then in March, I am not 100% sure what we're doing yet, but I'm sure we'll come up with something fun for you guys to do. Maybe something Easter related. So I just wanted to say thank you again for supporting me, and let's get this peeled off. So the trick with this is it needs to be a little bit wet to peel off. And it's okay if it bled under. I mean, it is what it is. Not the end of the world. So this might have been that it wasn't tight enough on there, and that's fine. Like, I have a little spot that got a little goob on it, and that's okay. So what you can do after this is all dry and everything is you can take a Q-tip and you can get that wet and then go over any little spots. But just know if you get it on a lot of paint, it's going to smear it a lot. So what I like to do is just do a little spot, then dry it with the other side of the Q-tip, and then do a little bit, and then dry it. So I am going to let this dry a little bit before we take off the vinyl that is still left on our board. I prefer that to be dry when I take that part off. So wet for the first part and dry for the second part. So while that's going, I'll get our glue gun and glue on the paper clip for you so you can see what that looks like, and then we'll finish the product. All right, welcome back. So far we have everything painted. We still have our vinyl stuck down. We got a paper clip glued on while we were waiting. We got our favorite picture of somebody we love, and we love Elise at the library, and my family and I love Elise. So she's going to be going on by board. So we are going to start picking out the parts that are still left on here. So if you're wondering, because it's painted over and you're like, well, what's still left? The hat, when you're looking at your board on the left, the nose on the left, and once again, you don't want to wait too long in between, but you just want it dry enough that you can grab these without it bleeding on you. The heart on the left, the center of the O's, the center of the G, and the center of the E's. Heart is good in the middle. The hearts on the right need to be peeled. Bigger hearts. And then the center is okay on that. The nose, the gnome on the right. And his beard on the right. And that will be it for that. Yeah, all right, perfect. So, since my picture is a little bit long, I'm going to trim it. So, you can put your clip wherever you would like. So, I love you like no other, Elise. So this is our finished product. It will probably be better for a landscape picture versus the horizontal. So that is our picture that we have and our gnome. So once again, this will be available in the red and the white. You'll get everything included except for the picture here. Otherwise, you can choose the gray and the red. And if you'd like to come into the library to see it, you're welcome to too, and check it out. Everything will be pre-stained and ready to go, and then all you have to do is come in and grab your kit on Fridays. They will be available, and then paint them. So thank you so much, and I hope you guys have fun painting these. Bye.